Hello everyone, ito na naman si GP ng Programmers Code Posting. So, may internet na ulit. Although, nawawala yung main light ko, kaya mukha tayong murder mystery and makeup. Anyway, yung tatalakayan natin today is something na tinatanong ako palagi, which is how I transition to data engineering. From software engineering. From being a full stack web developer into data engineering, right? I really wanted to go into the data space, right? So, yun talaga yung gusto kong gawin. I had a course in college na cognitive psych, and we had a topic on AI, and that I made use of it a lot. So, dun ako nahilig nun. I did research on AI, and then I created like ML models, for example, figuring out if what would be the performance of an employee given a set of variables. So, anyway, it wasn't that good because wala din proper data, obviously, pero I just tried it. Pero yun, I was working as a full stack web developer, I was really into AI then. I was studying AI, I was giving talks about AI. So tapos pupunta akong Manila kahit na like halos wala akong pera to talk about AI, right? So yeah, I was studying it, and then nagkaroon ng time na sa isang company that I joined na i-move kami ng project. So, at that time, hindi namin alam kung saan ka i-move. So, my manager at the time asked me kung saan project ko gusto. Sabi ko, kung saan merong data. So, at that time, dun pumapasok yung ano. So, one thing that I learned from transition is you need two things, right? One is mindset, second is luck. So, mindset tapos swerte, okay? So, yung swerte dito pumasok kasi magaling yung manager ko. Sabi ko sa kanya, gusto kong sa isang data project. Doesn't matter data science or data engineering or whatnot, right? Basta makapasok ako. I just need to get my foot in the data space. That's it. Sinabi niya sa akin na mag-ano daw ako. Sa resume ko, ayusin ko daw yung ano. Ilagay ko lang yung puro data lang. Yung lahat ng related ng kay data. So, I took trainings. So, walang prescribed na training na ganito. Pero naghanap ako, naghalongkot ako ng mga training na pwede kong kunin for data. Tapos, tinapos ko yung mga certifications na quote-unquote certifications within the company. Tapos, para yun yung ilagay ko sa resume ko na ito yung nandito. So, hindi ko in-include yung mga ano, yung mga related to web. Tapos, sinabi ko, ito yung alam ko. Okay, ganito lahat. It's a good thing na ano, magaling siya makipag-usap sa mga tao or like, yun nga. So, naipaglaban niya ako na malagay dun sa project na yun. Pero, again, that is luck. So, magaling yung manager ko. Number two is mindset din. So, prior to all that, nag-training ako sobra. Like, I was one of the top few dun sa buong company of like, super raming employees na napakarami yung, ano, yung certifications within the company. I did a lot of certifications just to move to, ano, to that projects. And it did happen, right? So, again, luck and then mindset then. So I needed to build the skills para makalipat. So I learned a lot and then moved into the project. And then yung tinanong ako kung ano yung skill level ko, even if hindi wala pa akong hands-on, I was pretty confident that I could learn it. So sinabi ko na I did a white lie na sabi sa akin, like, marunong ko ba mag Java? Sabi ko, hindi ako marunong Java. Marunong ako Java, pero like I didn't want to tell them na marunong ako. Tapos sabi, marunong ka ba mag-Kafka, right? So sabi sa akin, mga 6 siguro, pero I haven't touched it, pero I'm confident I can learn it, so something like that. So and so yun yung ano nila, assessment nila, and then I was able to move it to the project. And then pagdating ko dun, puro kami data engineer, hindi naman lahat, pero like most of us, kasi right, so yung drive nila at the time, pag wala kang data engineering, then wala kang hindi mo din maayos yung data science project mo. So, may data scientists, yes, pero there wasn't much data science work. Kasi, a lot of the data science work was done already, like may model na. But the thing is, kailangan nilang ipasok yung data. So, ayun, yun yung pinagagawa namin. We learned data engineering. Kahit, a lot of us, marami sa amin, nag-transition din. May mga iba din na fresh graduates, right, na wala pang alam talaga anything and just came into the project. So that's how I transitioned. And then from there, I built my skills, right? Read books, more books, trainings, etc. So I veered off from data science. So I started veering off of data science kasi na-realize ko na, yeah, data science is hard work, pero marami din nagpo-pursue ng data science, but not a lot of people are pursuing the foundations of getting the data to data scientists. So yun yung mga challenges, I guess. So that's how I transitioned. Again, one is mindset, second is luck. Sorta ako na magaling yung manager ko, shoutouts kay Sir Donnie. And also, there was also one who moved me from when I was working with Kafka, and I didn't want to touch Java anymore. So, nagpa-move ako to another team that uses Python and the whole big data stack like Hadoop and all that. The traditional Hadoop stack, right? So, ayun, sorted din ako dun sa kanya. Shoutouts kay Migs for helping me move as well. A bunch of stuff really happened for me to transition, but I needed to. One, swerte talaga ako, and then even before that, I was building the skills talaga. I had the mindset, I never stopped learning about the different things that I would need, right? So kahit nga ngayon, even na hindi na ako nag-AI or ML, I am still to some extent in the loop kasi part din ng data engineering yung ML ops, how to, like, you know, it's a whole thing, right? How to deploy these models, paano mag-feature engineering, dealing with feature stores para consistent yung training and inferencing mo with regards to features and those kinds of things. So, sobrang rami yung kailangan inaral ko for data engineering. And right now, I'm still learning. Maraming things na parang wala sila sa roadmap tapos kailangan mo talagang hanapin. So those are things na hinahanap ko pa din right now. So even now, the transition is still not done. Pero yeah, I think that's essentially how I transitioned to data engineering. Anyway, so that's it. If you have any questions about like my journey to transitioning, let me know and I will try to answer in the comments or kung i-message mo na ako or whatnot, right? So that's it. See you all next time.